The coal goes in through here, and the fire will heat the water, which will generate steam. This will also produce smoke all through the smoke. And then up through the boiler exhaust uptakes, which then goes to one of the first three exhausts. The steam that gets produced will travel through the pipes towards the back of the ship. It takes as much as 24 hours to start producing steam, so they have to start preparing long before the ship will leave the harbor. This steam makes it all the way to the inside of this room are two reciprocating steam engines. These engines are 3 stories tall, even by today's standards. That's enormous. Inside of each engine, there are 4 cylinders. Inside of each cylinder is a piston. The steam comes in and pushes the piston up and then down. This happens over and over. All 4 cylinders working together turn the shaft down the road. Each shaft goes out through the back of the ship and connects to the propellers. Don't forget, there's a third propeller blade out in the middle, but this one is powered by a different engine. Leftover steam from the reciprocating engines goes to the next room of the low-pressure turbine engine. The steam is used to turn the center shafts, which then turns the third propeller blade at the back. So the outside propeller blades are powered by the reciprocating steam engines, and the center propeller is powered by the low-pressure turbine engine. The leftover steam from the turbine engine goes to the condensers. This turns the steam into water again, where it can then be recycled back to the boiler. Fresh water is stored in large tanks here. This can be used as drinking water throughout the ship. This is the electric engine room. There are 4 electric engines that use steam to make electricity for the entire ship. There were also 2 backup engines behind here. On the night the Titanic sank, this area of the ship didn't take on water until the very end. The electricians kept these motors running as long as possible to keep the lights on. They were heroes. The Titanic had a system of 15 watertight bulkheads, which made 16 watertight compartments. If the ship was damaged and water started filling one of these compartments, it shouldn't spill over into any of the others. Or at least that's the idea. The watertight bulkheads separate the lower decks in the Titanic. For example, if there are watertight bulkheads in every floor. But the crew members need to be able to get through that bulkhead. That's why they use watertight doors. Normally they are not open, but in an emergency, they can be closed in just a few seconds.